Hi, my name is Batavia Sumlin, and I'm a virtual specialist for the Georgia Department of Education. Today, we'll be covering the SDLC. Our objectives today is for you to understand the software development lifecycle, to identify how you, as a high school student, use the software development lifecycle in your daily life, to define and understand each phase of the SDLC, and to recognize how the SDLC is used in the real world. Let's get started. Think of a project or a task that you have done recently in your studies. You probably used some form of the SDLC in planning for that particular project or assignment. When you are using the SDLC, you're going through a phase. You start from the planning phase, which is identifying what the assignment or project will be about. Then going into the analysis phase, which you are analyzing how to actually solve a problem. Then transversing into the design phase, where you are going to end up designing what your project is going to entail and what it should look like. Next, we go into our implementation phase, where you are going to actually implement what you have learned and what you have put together. Going into the testing phase, where you take your design project and give it to your teacher or your peers in order to test it to see if it works properly. And lastly, deployment, where you are pushing it out to the public in order for it to be used. In the automotive industry, the SDLC is used to develop software systems for vehicles, such as navigation systems, entertainment systems, and safety systems. This helps the automakers to offer more advanced and convenient features for their vehicles. In the healthcare industry, the SDLC is used to develop electronic medical record systems, medical imaging software, and other medical technology products. This helps healthcare providers to better manage patient data and improve patient care to reduce the risk of errors. In the education industry, the SDLC is used to develop software systems for schools and universities, such as the learning management systems, like eClass, or e-learning platforms such as Google Classroom. This helps educators to better manage student data, improve student engagement, and to provide more effective learning experiences. Lastly, in the tech industry, the SDLC is used to develop software products such as mobile apps, websites, and computer programs. Companies like Apple, Google, and Microsoft use the SDLC to ensure that their software is developed efficiently and effectively. In the software development lifecycle, there are several different models that you can use in order to develop your products. In particular, these are the top six models that you will encounter either in school or in the workforce. First up, we have the waterfall model. It is a simple and straightforward model that is linear in its approach, going step by step through each task within the cycle. Next up, we have the agile model, which is a more flexible and iterative model that emphasizes collaboration and customer satisfaction. This is one of the models that you use more frequently in your day-to-day life. Next up is the spiral model. It is a combination of both the waterfall model and the agile model, where each phase is completed in a series of iterations. Next up is the prototype model, which is an interactive model where a working prototype is created, tested, and refined until it meets the customer requirements. You often use this model in your science and engineering courses. The V model is a sequential model that connects each phase to the corresponding testing phase. And lastly, we have the Scrum model, which is a type of agile model that emphasizes self-organization and teamwork. The top three models used in school are waterfall, agile, and Scrum. Some examples of assignments where you might have used these are creating a website or a computer game, designing and building a 3D prototype, or programming a robot to do a specific task. Now that you've learned about the different SDLC models, you might be asking yourself, well, how can I apply these skills to a job? First off, you could be a project manager or business analyst, where you oversee the overall production of an item. You could also be a software architect or developer. You could be a software tester, where you find the bugs within a particular program. You could consider being a technical writer, where you can write the end user guides for your users. Lastly, you could be a DevOps engineer or a user experience designer, where you interact with the end users in developing the user experience. Thank you for watching this presentation. If you have any additional questions or concerns, please feel free to contact the Georgia Department of Education. Thank you. See you next time.